Hi, and welcome to the Comfy Red Couch. My name is Tracy, and I'm your host, and I am coming to you from a very rainy day in Toronto. But that's okay, because even if it is gray and rainy outside, I'm just happy to be inside and having a chance to chatter with you about what I've gotten up to this week, which, when I look over to my right, isn't very much, but it's enough to have a nice little chat about this week, and that's okay. And I'll talk about that a little bit more in bits and bobs. And of course, the whole isolation time and COVID-19, we'll chatter about that in bits and bobs. But for now, welcome to the podcast. As I said, my name is Tracy. If you would like to find me, I am Tracy RR on Ravelry, and I am at Comfy Red Couch on Instagram. If you're new to the podcast, welcome. This is a podcast that is usually about knitting, but this week I'm branching off a little bit, so I'm excited to share that with you. So welcome. Grab a seat, grab a cup of whatever it is, grab your project of choice, and I hope that you enjoy what I'm going to be chattering about. And if you are a returning viewer, welcome back. You know I always, always love having you here. And this week is no different. So I'm hoping that you have, while the rain is really starting to come down now outside, I don't know if you can hear it or not, but it is raining buckets, buckets and buckets. Anyway, welcome back. I know you've got your tea, coffee, glass of wine, glass of juice, glass of water, whatever it is that you're drinking, and you are snuggled up in your own little space, and you are ready to start talking about crafting. So it is now tea time, and today I am drinking out of my Lady of the House kitty mug, and this is a Rendale Designs, and I think it's Royal Albert. Royal Albert's the other China. Anyway, this is Royal Worcester Rendale Designs, and it doesn't have anything in it yet. And that's because today I made a little stump teapot tea concoction of the loose tea of Marks and Spencer. So extra strong loose tea. So this is going to be very, very strong because I made it a little bit ago. And it's been waiting and steeping, so it's probably going to be super, super strong. But yes, just regular, extra strong black tea. I am now out of my bags, and I'm now into the loose tea. And that's okay. This is a good time to get through my stash. Anyway, what shall we cheer to today? It is rainy. But after the rain comes the rainbow. Kind of like how many of us are probably feeling, that we're feeling it's a little bit, the whole social isolating is a little bit rainy feeling, but the rainbow will come soon enough. So cheers to rainbows, and we'll endure the rain in the meantime. Just think about how green the grass is going to get and those gorgeous flowers, all because of a little bit of watering. I love my Marks and Spencer tea. It's now time for my favorite things, and I have not been up to my usual things this week. This week I was playing with my new sewing machine, and I even did a little bit of hand sewing, but I'll show off what I was doing with my sewing machine first. Now last week I had cut out my pieces for my Rob Bluet, and this is a pattern by Deer and Doe, and this pattern that I am using is the first version, which is a printed copy. There is now a new version, which is printed and PDF, and I do have that version as well, but it is different in the sleeves, and it's also different in sizing. The PDFs of the new version go up a few more sizes than the print versions do. So this is my Rob Bluet, and last week I was saying I don't have any thread, but I was actually able to order some online, and can't show it during brown paper packages because it's on the sewing machine right now. But it's called muslin. It's an Aurifil thread, and it matches pretty well, I think. So for what I need it to do, it's pretty good. So my robe bleue, I have sewn the sides of my dress all together. So it's starting to look like a dress. I've just clipped it at the top for the shoulders, and maybe I'll pop it on for you. But right now, all I've done is I have very, very raw edges for my seams right now. I have ironed them out. I've put them together and ironed them, and I now just need to finish the seams off. And I had been planning to do that a couple of days ago, and then yesterday, but yesterday I got into something else, so I will get to it. And so right now, just raw seams, and I will get to it. But my goodness, look at, I'm hoping it's showing up, this cute bow. This bow, let me just hold it there, is just too adorable. And I'll hold it on my front. So this is on the back. It would be on the back, but right now I'm holding it on my front. Anyway, this is my robe bleue, and I'm going to put it on even though I've got clothes on, and it's, I'm probably going to pop off those clips at the top, but that's not the end of the world. Oops, there goes one. So this is the robe bleue and that cute little bow. But the problem is, as I said, the sizing is a little bit smaller on the paper version. And even though I've been trying to drop a little bit of weight, I'm not quite, I don't think, and plus I've got a shirt or two on, it's going to be a little bit snug at first, but I'm working on that. So anyway, it does kind of close up here, but then of course, and oh my gosh, that bow is too cute, but I've got to work on it a little bit. Anyway, my dress is coming along. I'm obviously not going to be in a rush to finish it because it's not going to fit me straight away. It will fit me at some point, but not as soon as I, well, depends how long it takes me to finish it. Anyway, I am enjoying working on it. And even though I was disappointed when I put it on the other day and went, oh, it's not quite going to fit, even though with the measurements and everything, I'm very close. So we'll get there. I will get there. Anyway, in the meantime, I have a dress under construction with, oh, did I mention the cutest little bow? It is just, I was debating not adding this bow, but I think I really, really am so glad that I did. Anyway, this is the Penny Arcade fabric from Cotton and Steel. And I have not figured out what buttons I'm going to use. I do have some Merchant and Mills sort of mother of pearl type buttons or shell buttons. I'm not sure what it's made of, but I may just use those because those will be very simple and classic to put on here. I might just look through my buttons and see if I've got anything else that stands out that goes really nicely. But this week, I do hope to finish those seams inside the dress. And it would be really great to get to the point where I have sewn off the shoulders so that when I put it on, it doesn't unclip on me. And I've still got to do the facings and all the little bits and pieces that will go along with this dress. So I have been enjoying sitting down at my new sewing machine and spending a little bit of time. And what I did this week is I absconded with Greg's good chair that he never uses anyway, and I put it at my sewing desk. What a difference. I was able to sew from, I guess, about 4 o'clock Friday evening till maybe 6:30, 7 o'clock. And when I got up from the chair, my back was not all angry at me. So it really did make a difference having a good chair in there. So Greg has now said I can just have that chair in there, and I'm very, very thankful for that. Anyway, this is my Rob Bleuet, which hopefully by later spring will fit properly and will be done. But yeah, that is one of the things that I worked on this week and really, really enjoyed spending some time with. The next project that I'm going to share with you is another sewing project. And this project is from a workshop that I did quite a while back ago at UKnit, which is a local yarn shop / sewing shop in Toronto. And I am doing the hand-stitched baby quilt. And this is a pattern that we started working on during the workshop. And I got to the point where I had sandwiched my batting between my fabric, and I was then at the hand sewing part. And then it got put in the bag, brought home, and not worked on for quite some time. And at the very beginning of January, end of December of this year, I picked it up and started doing the hand stitching, more in January, I think. And I really enjoyed doing that. So this is the fabric on the one side that I'm using, and it's green pansies. I believe it's Wyndham Fabrics, and there's something about a porch. I'll put the name of the fabric there. So that's one side. And then the other side is this gorgeous Liberty print called Marta. And this is a Tana Lawn. And oh, I love how the two of these together are just so springy and bright and cheerful. So I decided yesterday that I needed to clear off the island and lay this down and start drawing lines. So I have drawn horizontal lines across the green side of this fabric because I didn't want to put it on this side and then have the possibility that maybe it doesn't wash off. So it is a fabric marker that I have used, and there are little horizontal lines going across. Not sure if you can see them or not, but yeah, much better to have them on the green side where it blends in. And so what I'm doing now is I am just doing the hand stitching part of this blanket. And the secret of this blanket is you start working on it before washing your fabric. So you don't pre-wash your fabric. And each side of this is about a yard and a quarter. And then you just, once you've got it all finished along the sides and the batting is inside, you then hand stitch. And so I've got three boxes, and I'll show you the light side because it's a little bit easier. Three boxes around the outside of the blanket, and then on the inside I'm now doing horizontal stripes. And for those stripes I am using DMC flosses. I'm using this gorgeous dark green, like a foresty kind of green, emerald green, and then I'm using this gorgeous spring green. So these two are my flosses of choice. I thought they went really nicely, not only with this side, they blend in a little bit more on this side, but even though they're not really seen as much, I didn't want too wild on this side. And I was a little bit afraid if I used red, the red might bleed into the white. It's possible the green might bleed, but usually DMC is pretty good. Anyway, this is the hand stitching that I got up to yesterday. I'll hold it this way so it's horizontal. And what I did was I had already had most of the three outer boxes done, and I finished off the last of the outer boxes. And then with my lines as a guideline, I started doing the hand sewing horizontal lines. And I am doing 4 lines of the bright green, then 4 lines of the dark green, and then 4, 4, back and forth. So there are 72 lines total, which will nicely work out to 4 lines of each of these colors before I get back down to the bottom box out section. So once I have finished doing all of that hand sewing, I will then throw it in the washing machine and then in the dryer. And because the fabric has not been pre-washed, what will happen is it will shrink up a little bit and sort of wrinkle up the fabric, and especially between all of the stitch lines, and make it into a nice squishy blanket. And oh my goodness, it's going to be so soft. This is going to be for me, and this is just going to be a lovely lap blanket for when I'm down on the couch working on different projects. So something that's a little bit mindless, but it took a really, really long time to draw those lines yesterday. I think it took me about 2 to 2.5 hours just drawing those lines, and it took a lot of patience, but it's going to be absolutely gorgeous when it is done. So that is project number 2 that I worked on this week. And again, I mainly started this one, or the work that I've done on it this week, yesterday. And as I said, I drew all of the lines, took me about 2.5 hours. And then last night, we watched a little bit of TV, and I just did 8 rows or horizontal lines of the stripes on the blanket. So a little bit here, a little bit there, and I think I will have this done by the end of spring. So maybe sooner, soon. We'll see how long when it kind of pulls me. At least now that the lines are in place, it's a lot easier to just pick it up and do a little bit of stitching. Well, before I had put it down because I knew I had to draw those lines, and it was tedious. It was definitely tedious, but kind of like this whole self-isolation stuff, it's tedious, but the hard work now will be worth it in the end. And so that was sort of as I was drawing the lines, thinking about the hard stuff we're doing now is going to turn into something beautiful in the end. The rainbow. Anyway, that was project 2 that I worked on this week. Now I have one more project to share with you that I worked on, and that was living in my gorgeous little Bobbins spring birdie bag. And this is the pattern for the Handmade Sock Society that was released this past Tuesday. And these are the ambient socks that I'm going to be sharing with you. But first I will share my yarn. I used this gorgeous skein of Gurple on Super Sock by Nora George Yarns. And oh, just love it. And I did get this as seconds because there was this little tiny bit of orange dye that jumped into Gurple's pots. And it's added just that little bit of fun. Last week I was able to find a little bit of orange to show you. There might be a little bit in there, but I can't really tell without my glasses on. I'll find a couple spots on the socks. But yes, this was the yarn that I used for the ambient socks. And I knew last week when I spoke with you that I was not going to have both of them done in time for release. So I did have the one already done by last week, and that was photographed, ready to go. And then I worked on sock 2 and got it done. So these are the ambient socks. And the ambient socks have, let me just pull one off right now. The ambient socks have this gorgeous lace pattern on the front. And then on the back has a fun, different kind of striped texture on the back. And then it leads into a, I think it's the bird's eye heel. Something with a bird heel, heel flap. And then a beautiful gusset, because I do like my gussets. And then lace down the foot. And then it has a nice round wedge toe. I've got a little bit of an ear happening there. But the ambient socks in Gurpal, they remind me of lilacs. And I love, love, love lilacs. Now, I talked about the little bit of orange jumping into the dye pots. And so on this one, there was a little bit of orange that popped on the top of the socks. And then on my, that was my second sock, I believe. And then on my can't even see it now. On my first sock, there were a couple little spots of orange that popped up, but I just thought they added a little bit more dimension. I can't even see them now. So I was quite happy to have seconds of Gurpal, and now I have a gorgeous pair of ambient socks to go in my operation sock drawer. Just lacy, perfect color for spring. So that is a finished object, which now brings my total on my Ravelry page down yet another one. I think I'm now down to 6 works in progress. And I'm pretty sure I'm trying to think about whether I spent any time with the boxy. I don't think I did. And I'm just checking. My dragon is exactly where I left it with you last week. So I didn't think I had any time with the boxy. But this will be maybe a project I'll work on a little bit this week. My boxy sweater. And I've not done much knitting this week. Finished off some socks, did lots of sewing. This week, yeah, maybe I'll spend a little bit of time with this. I do have the pattern for April's Sock Society, and I have my yarn all picked out. I have it all put in a project bag. I probably should start that in the next couple of days, just because I was so behind, even though I thought I had lots of time. I think with this isolation and the whole COVID-19, where I did have a lot of time, I just wasn't in the mindset to do a lot of knitting, especially in a pattern that required a little bit more thinking. So I did not get this done on time, even though I had enough time to do it, but the mindset wasn't there. And sometimes that happens, and I just have to learn to forgive myself when I cannot meet those deadlines because, you know, other stuff is going on. And right now in the world, other stuff is definitely going on. So the knitting, it'll get done when it gets done. Anyway, that is all I have for my favorite things this week. It was really nice to bring some sewing in, and hopefully next week I'll have a little bit more knitting. It's now time for brown paper packages, and this week I had some thread come in. As I showed you my dress, my Robe Bleue, I had some, it was muslin by Aurifil, and it was just some thread that came in the mail. But I also had a couple other things that are completely not craft related, but I thought I would share with you. So with Nathaniel being home from school, I bought flashcards, so division and multiplication. You can't go wrong with drilling in the math facts. So I got a couple of those. I've been having Nathaniel do the times table chart every morning, so he gets that done, and then he does an hour of reading, and I'm not stressing too much about it, but I did get the flashcards just to kind of help solidify some of those math skills, just the basics. And then another thing I got is called Mindful Kids, and I do have this company makes something called yoga pretzels, and when Nathaniel was in grade one, his teacher used yoga pretzels, and so I really liked these cards, and I had had my eye on these when I discovered that they made these in maybe December or January. I discovered that this was out there called Mindful Kids, and so I thought this would be a good thing to maybe get and just have some activities. So it's 50 mindfulness activities for kindness, focus, and calm. And so this one is wake up your mind and your body. And this is mindful breaths. And I'm gonna need to put my glasses on to read it. And so our moods often affect the way we act. If you're happy, you might act kind or generous. If you're grumpy, you might act mean or selfish. It is wise to understand our moods and how they affect what we say or do. And the first step is to each morning sit mindfully with your spine straight and your body relaxed. Take three soft, slow, mindful breaths and notice your mood. Where do you feel your mood? Put your hand there. Does it feel heavy like clay or light as a feather? Number two, now choose a marker or crayon and draw your mood. Blue could mean one mood, red or green could mean another, you choose. And then the third one, keep your mood drawing where you can see it again. It helps remind you how you've been feeling. Later on, you might be in a different mood, so create a new drawing and let the old mood go. And by paying attention to your mood in the morning, you can change how you act throughout the day. So that's just one of the cards, and there are 50 different ones. So mountain rising, open ears, rain shower. Maybe that's the one I should have. Wash away your busy thoughts. Maybe that's the one I should have done today with the rainy day. So rain shower, wash away your busy thoughts. Number one, sit mindfully with your spine straight and body relaxed. Close your eyes and take three soft, slow, mindful breaths. Two, pay attention to the thoughts in your mind. Are they busy, busy, busy? I know mine have been busy, busy, busy. Number three, imagine your thoughts as dust clinging to your skin. Now four, now imagine going out into a warm, pleasant rain. The rain washes off the dust and your thoughts drain away. Five, imagine the sun comes out and dries your skin and clothes. Six, take three more soft, slow, mindful breaths and notice whether your mind feels more at ease. Sometimes it takes practice to let your thoughts drain away because your mind holds on to them. Try this exercise again day after day. So today is a rainy day. Let's get that rainbow out there and wash away those negative thoughts that sometimes we do get. So that came in the mail this week, a nice brown paper package, and I thought that I would do some activities with Nathaniel as we stay inside over this time, and some days are a little bit more difficult than others, but yeah, that was Mindful Kids, and that is by Barefoot Books, Step Inside a Story, so barefootbooks.com. So yeah, it was all about the flashcards this week and home education, but yeah, I'm trying not to stress too much about it. So what I've been doing, just sit, have a nice cup of tea, relax, and that is what I have for brown paper packages this week. It's now time for Bits and Bobs, and this is my segment where I talk about anything and everything not necessarily knitting related, and Scout has decided that she's going to turn around on the couch there for a little bit. And yes, it has been a week all around the world. Unprecedented. I think many of us are not sure what to think. I know Canada sort of had, even though it happened really, really quickly, little things have been happening day by day. But I've noticed when I read about other places in the world, it's like an instant lockdown or a very, very quick shutdown, and a lot faster than it's interesting to see all the different jurisdictions and what's happening. So I am trying to embrace, because that's my word of the year, this new reality of working at home, staying at home, being at home pretty much 24/7. And I'm a bit of a homebody, so I'm actually embracing it at this point fairly well. So that is good. Although I did have a little bit of a rough patch later in the week. I got some news that I wasn't too happy about, but that kind of stuff happens. So anyway, it is what it is, and I've got to move on. There's going to be a rainbow that comes out of that bad news, and it's okay. It's okay. It's c'est la vie, or que sera, sera, whatever you want to say. Anyway, yesterday I made an apple crisp. I then drew those lines, and I have been trying to do the things that I need to do. The one thing I've had a really hard time about is figuring out my balance of work and of home. So last week, the previous week, I was on a week holiday, but this past week I've been back to work and trying to figure out what that looks like. So I did have a couple of teleconferences or video conferences, little staff meetings, and I did have some paperwork that I had to get done, and so I went upstairs. But the hard part that I've been having is shutting off at the end of the day, and at the end of the workday I should not check my email. And Friday I kind of went a little bit beyond that time and checked it a couple times, and Thursday. So I've been having a hard time sort of figuring out those boundaries. And I think as I go along, that will get a little bit easier. The routine in the morning has been fairly good. I've been getting up 8:30, 9 o'clock, and you know, coming downstairs, I've been making coffee for Greg and Isaac. I've been putting out the math for Nathaniel for when Nathaniel comes down. And Monday, it was a struggle to do my version of homeschooling. And there were lots of tears and tempers and stomping of feet about the one page of math that I gave. And really, it was just the times table, fill in the chart. And I decided I was just gonna have him do that every single day this past week, to sort of get those numbers drilled in. And there were several mistakes on Monday, but I have to say Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday, he had it perfect. But Monday was lots of stomping feet about the times table, and what should have maybe been 15, maybe 20 minutes to do took 3 hours. But that was okay. I just, here it is, you gotta get it done. And there was lots of gnashing of teeth for sure. And then followed by an hour of reading. And then Tuesday, it was, here it is, and he actually got to it no problem. And that was one of my teleconference days, and Nathaniel brought his book up and sat down beside me, and I was probably teleconferencing for about an hour, and he just sat and read, and at the end of that time, he was done, and that was an easy day. And then Wednesday, I put it out for him. He came down, he worked on it, did his reading, no problem. Thursday, he actually went, got it from over at the printer and started it on his own. There was a little bit of complaint about the reading that day. And the afternoon was a little rough that day for him, but he did go out for a scooter ride with Isaac. The two of them went for a nice bit of exercise, and I think he needed to get outside, and it was sunny that day as well, I believe. And then Friday, it was one more bit of math, and the reading was a bit of a challenge, though I think he went over his reading time. I think he read for about an hour and a half, so that wasn't bad. And I'm trying not to stress too much, and as I said, I was trying to figure out my own work, life, housework balance, and I will get there. I'll figure it all out. I think last week was a very quiet week. This week I think it's going to ramp up a little bit more. And then I think after that we'll be a little bit more full steam ahead. And I'm really going to need to figure out what those boundaries are and make sure that I do turn off the email at the end of the workday. It needs to go away. And any work that I need to do that I haven't gotten done will need to wait till the next day, so that, you know, working hours are working hours. And you know, I've got to fit lunch in there, and that was always a problem when I was at work. So I'll figure it all out. I hope that during this COVID-19 crisis that you are all doing well, and that you are figuring out what your new normal looks like, and if you are able to work from home, that you're figuring that balance out. But if you are still having to go out for work, I want to say thank you. You are definitely an unsung hero, and whether you are working in a grocery store or a pharmacy, whether you are having to do some sort of city service, or whether you are working in the hospitals, healthcare, whether you're working in social services, whatever it is you're doing, that you're still needing to get out there and reach the people you need to, thank you for that. That's huge, and so necessary. So it is a hard time for sure, and I know a lot of people are having struggles with the isolation. Today I am recording a little bit early because I am going to join a knitting, I'm going to say crafting, because I'm going to work on my blanket while I'm chattering away. Maybe I'll work on my boxy. We'll see. But I am joining a virtual craft group this afternoon, and I'm looking forward to that. So that's why I thought I would record a little bit early, so that I can then join in and chatter with some people around the world. And I'm looking definitely forward to meeting some new people online, and just having a chatter about what things are like in other places, because everything's sort of happening at different speeds all around the world. Anyway, I am hoping that you are hanging in there. And as I said, my word for the year has been embrace, and embracing this is what I am trying my best to do. And yeah, some days are a little bit more difficult than others. Today seems like a pretty good day, and I'm just so happy that I'm having a chance to visit with you. Anyway, I think that's all I've got to share on Bits and Bobs this week. I'm hoping that I do figure out this work-life balance, because even though, you know, I did have three things to share with you, I don't feel like I put a lot of time into crafting this week as maybe I would have if my life had been on its normal sort of routine. But that's okay. I'm just doing some slow crafting and enjoying that crafting. I was thinking about how much I'm enjoying my new sewing machine last night. So anyway, that is all I have for Bits and Bobs this week. Thank you so much for joining me on the Comfy Red Couch this week. I hope that you've had a chance to sit down and relax, and that you've had a chance to work on that project of choice. Feed your body, mind, and soul with some beverage, some crafting, and some chatter. And I am wishing you a wonderful week ahead. I'm wishing you a healthy week, a happy week, a restful week. One thing I'm going to say, the bags under my eyes are going to be gone, I think, I hope, once I sort of get into a good routine, especially with the waking and sleeping. I'm trying to keep that organized, but yeah, once I get into a good pattern, I think I won't be as tired anymore, and I'm looking forward to that. Anyway, I am wishing you a restful week ahead, filled with many blessings, and I hope that you are able to connect with the people that you love, and I hope to see you next week on the Comfy Red Couch. Bye. I'm going to end you off with one more mindful card, and this one is called Breath by Breath. And yes, we definitely need to take everything breath by breath. At the very bottom it says, pause in the present moment. And this one headline is loving kindness. Sit mindfully with your spine straight and body relaxed. Hold your hand over your heart and repeat to yourself, may I be happy, may I be safe, may I be peaceful, may I be kind. Okay. Number three, now think of a friend or a family member. Repeat to yourself, may you be happy, may you be safe, may you be peaceful. May you be kind. And I want you to know I was thinking about you. Number four. Now imagine people you don't know yet. Repeat to yourself. May you all be happy. May you all be safe. May you all be peaceful. May you all be kind. Number five. Continue your day knowing that everyone wants to be happy, just like you do. And I think that's a nice way to end off today. So, may you be happy, may you be safe, may you be peaceful, may you be kind.